Hi, we're back on the Shtick with Tania de Jong. AM, and it's PM now, and she's in a hurry, so we'll do this one quickly. What I wanted to talk to you about was this wonderful musical that has been created, all about your family, your heritage, your legacy. Tell us about it.
Well, it's all of our stories, Henry. You know, it's your story and it's your
story. No, this story is unique.
Well, there are some really things about it that are certainly unique.
Absolutely. Everyone's story is unique.
Well, of course, of course. But it does reflect many of the stories that we have about the Holocaust in particular. But, I mean, this story is the story that my mum wrote. So she wrote the book Driftwood in 2017. And it was shortlisted for a number of literary awards. So as a first-time author at, you know, the age of 80 or whatever.
Your mother.
Anyway, so it tells the story of my grandmother in particular, who invented the foldable umbrella, Slawa Horowitz-Duldig.
Horowitz.
Yeah, and she invented the foldable umbrella in Vienna in 1929, which is an incredible thing to do, especially for a woman, you know, at that time. And so that invention was manufactured in this Austrian factory for the next decade, and it's still manufactured actually in that same factory
today.
Because recently I was giving a keynote speech on innovation, and this Austrian delegate came up and gave me this umbrella, this same exact model that he bought at that factory from Austria. But anyway, obviously 10 years went by, and then of course the Nazis in 1938-39 walked into Vienna. And so my grandmother and my grandfather, Karl Duldig, who was a very renowned sculptor, managed to bribe a border guard to sculpt his bust in exchange for three
passes
to get out of Vienna to go to Switzerland. And my mum was only a few months old at the time. And of course, we would not be here. I would certainly not be sitting here if it hadn't been for that piece of strategic foresight by my grandmother. She was a very... Yeah, she was a very tuned in woman, and not only highly creative and brilliant, but very tuned in.
And she was an artist in her own right.
Absolutely. Yep. She was an artist. My grandfather was a sculptor. And of course, she invented the foldable umbrella. And so when they got to Switzerland, the German authorities contacted them and said, you know, Mr. Duldig, we want to buy the patent from you. And not knowing, well, they brought the right to the royalties.
Really?
Yeah.
How very decent of them.
I know, really. So she kept the patent, though. So that was the deal that they did. So her name is still on the patent. So, you know, I was invited to Vienna to speak at a big innovation conference a couple of years ago, and the European Patent Office were there, and they actually showed me on the register my grandmother Slawa Horowitz's invention of the foldable umbrella. It was amazing. Anyway, so her and her sister, Rella.
Which is short for Umbrella.
Well, actually, that's interesting. I never thought of it.
Umber.
But any Rella, her
Umber
sister...
Umber is the light from the sun, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, Umber.
Well, Rella was an actress, and she married a Parisian, Marcel. And so they went to Paris, and they were able to save miraculously, and I don't want to tell viewers about how they did this, but
contents of their apartment.
They saved all the contents of the apartment, all the art and sculpture, furniture and everything.
How did they do that?
Well, you've got to come to see Driftwood to see this.
Driftwood.
And they hid it in this Parisian basement for decades, and it was like an incredible story. I don't even want to tell anyone what happened, because this comes up in the musical Driftwood. But effectively, what we did was we decided to adapt Mum's book into a musical. And so we commissioned a playwright, Jane Bodie, a composer, Anthony Barnhill, incredible musical
Amazing
director.
Amazing guy.
Incredible, like only
and
26.
And the director, who is
Wesley
this guy?
Wesley Enoch,
he's got an AM as well.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's indigenous.
Yeah, indigenous director.
What a beautiful man.
Yeah, incredible man.
Yeah,
and so he's directing the show. And we have Charlotte Lane, who's also an incredible designer. She's Jewish, actually, as well.
Yeah, I know Charlotte.
Yeah, and so we have this incredible cast and creative team. The cast, so I'm playing the role of my grandmother, Slava. Fem Belling's playing the role of Rella. Anton Berezin's playing the role of Karl Duldig.
Yeah, Duldig. Troy Sussman.
Troy Sussman's playing a variety of different roles, and Sarah Reed is playing the role of Eva, my mother. And so it's an amazing cast, all Jewish cast. We have a season that's premiering at the Alexander Theatre at Monash.
For 2 days?
Yep, 4 performances there, and then we transfer to Chapel Off Chapel. So this is the world premiere season.
You've got a whole week there.
Yeah, about
so this is a world premiere.
Yeah, it's so, a world premiere.
So at the Alexandra, it's 13th to the 14th of May.
Yeah.
And at the Chapel of Chapel, it's 18th to 28th of May.
That's right.
Now, I'd love to get you on before then, or somebody from the
maybe
cast.
One of the cast or Anthony.
Fem's been on the show.
Yeah, she'd be great.
It was so great to see her there. And I have to mention, I was there to film. You had a videographer, Sergio, who's absolutely fabulous. He is amazing. He filmed your,
shoot the other day.
And you had a photographer.
Yes, James.
James was there.
Yeah.
And I love the studio. We must mention it because we haven't mentioned the Duldig Studio.
The Duldig Studio. Yeah, well, of course, we filmed...
Well, that's where all the contents...
Well, that's where all the contents ended up.
Yes.
That's where all this furniture and art and sculpture ended up by miraculous feats of human ingenuity.
Incredible. And what a great story.
I know. But the sad thing was when my grandmother, Slava, said farewell to her sister Rella at the station in Vienna in 1939. You know, for many years they never actually knew that one or the other was alive. And of course, most of our relatives were killed in the Holocaust. Mm. But miraculously, they did both survive.
They reunited?
They wrote to one another for decades, and they only saw each other one more time in Paris in 1968.
Wow.
So it's a very powerful but also very sad and inspirational story of people being able to rebuild their lives after, you know, the horrors of the Holocaust and everything that had happened to them. Like, I look at my mother and I just think, wow, after everything that happened to you, it's extraordinary.
And she's still so vibrant and intelligent and creative at her age, which is wonderful.
Well, adversity can, either make or break us.
Yes, it certainly is. It's like a diamond, which is what my mother's maiden name was, Diamant.
Oh, that's interesting.
And she was very resilient as well. She survived and came through.
Well, resilience is very important now, especially because we constantly have change and we have to be adaptable and agile to it, to deal with constant change. But the other show that I also wanted to mention to you that I'm also premiering at the Jewish International Film Festival is my Songs for Psychedelic show, which was meant to premiere last year at the Melbourne Cabaret Festival and the Fringe Festival and a few other festivals.
Yes, unfortunately.
Yeah. And so now it's at GIF on the 19th and 20th of March at the Classic Cinemas. So this is really the story of my journey from singing to psychedelics.
Yep.
And there's lots of wonderful music in there, some original songs and some beautiful songs and some wonderful stories. It's just a short 1 hour show. And it's part of the live cabaret shows that GIF are doing alongside the films and so on.
Are you going to do it in the cabaret or is it going to be in, because I've got a little jazz
room. Yeah, it's in the little cabaret room.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah.
I'll be there filming it.
Great.
And it's been a real pleasure, a total delight having you in the studio. Thank you. I know you've got to rush off. You're doing 20 interviews in a day at the moment, something like that.
It's busy at the moment.
So thank you again. And we'll be back next week with more Shtick, because that's what we do.
The Shtick?
Yeah.
The Shtick.
We love the Shtick. Yeah.
And yes, you're going to play Shroom Boom and some trailers from Driftwood. And
That'll be on YouTube. We can't put any of that on Channel 31 because we've run way over time. But that's okay. Let's have...
Thank you.
Wish you lots of luck and success in everything that you do, because you are the doobie 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 doer of all time. Shana na na na. Shalom.
Shalom.
Alechem.
Alechem.
Driftwood, the musical, tells the amazing story of my mother, Slawa Horowitz, who invented the foldable umbrella in Vienna in 1929. She fell in love and married the acclaimed sculptor Karl Duldig. Their apartment in Vienna was full of their beautiful art and their customized furniture. My name is Eva de Jong Duldig. I was born in 1938. 1 month after I was born, Hitler marched into Vienna and we were forced to flee for our lives. I'm sitting here in one of the armchairs from the Viennese apartment. How did it and everything else get here? This is a photo of my mother with her beloved sister Rella. It was taken in Vienna in 1938, just before they were separated by the Second World War. How did we survive against all odds? To find out what happens, you must see this captivating show, written by Jane Bodie, with music by Anthony Barnhill and directed by Wesley Enoch, and with an outstanding cast as well as a highly talented creative team.
I love the shtick too.